Quas log. 18,400 feet. I'm heading for the Nien Diki Book Monastery.
It's so inspiring. Built right into the living rock. Since Bennett vanished, and Jomo Memo was less than helpful, I can only hope that the monk taught Pa is still alive in the monastery.
Thank you.
stand there. Something glittering. Isn't moving. There must be something else.
Thank you. Thank you. Welcome to the Nyendike Book Monastery, young Eric. I have been expecting you. I fear your journey until now has been a confusing one. Perhaps I can make things clearer. A year ago, I was studying in the monastery library when a trick of the light revealed that the ancient manuscript I was reading was actually a palimpsest, a scroll that had been written on, scraped off, and used again. What lay underneath was a breathtaking discovery. The location of an ancient terma. A terma is a key piece of wisdom that was written down in ancient times and magically hidden until such future time as the wisdom is needed. Only then does the terma come again to the light. I could not decipher the entire scroll, and so I brought it to Master Lama Kenpo Jigme Lingpa for him to study. But in the meantime, I also told my good friend Edward Bennett what I had found, and that the terma lay waiting to be collected high on the sacred one. Bennett could not wait for the remainder of the scroll to be translated. Impetuously, he embarked on a solo climb to retrieve the terma and suffered a terrible accident that resulted in the loss of his leg. By the time Bennett had recovered, Master Kenpo had deciphered the rest of the text. It was a prophecy about the man who would bring the terma down from the mountain. When I read the prophecy to Bennett, he immediately said that the words applied to your brother. Bennett brought your brother here and prepared him to climb the mountain. There were mundane preparations, of course, but also sacred ones. Normally, one cannot climb Chomolonzo unless one has journeyed on foot around the base of the mountain 12 times. Such a journey is known as a kora. Of course, Frank had not completed these koras, but Bennett persuaded Jomo Menmo's apprentice to perform a series of sacred rituals that would appease the goddess and allow Frank to approach her. The apprentice was a young girl named Ming Ma Yangzi. Something must have gone wrong. The day after Frank left camp, ghosts and demons started to appear. The Sherpas fled. My fellow monks fled. They have run away from the goddess for the very reason that you approach her. They flee themselves. You approach yourself.
Thanks all the same, mate. But I don't believe in your goddess. I'm just here to collect my brother and move on.
You don't need to believe in her. You have been fighting these ghosts that you do not believe in, yes? They are only going to get stronger. And if you do not prepare yourself to approach the mountain, ultimately, these ghosts will defeat you. You think this is about your brother, and it is, but it is also about you. Not all ghosts wish you harm. Seek out the spirits of our departed lamas and learn what they have to teach you.
Thank you.
record on tape.
Thank you.
Prepare yourself to face the terrible spirit that awaits inside the sanctum.
I think you should know. I'm not exactly a praying man.
Prayer is not necessary. Sit. Become calm. Enter within yourself. You will know when you are ready. For you. I believe your brother's spirit may have passed into the bardo.
You mean he's dead?
Not exactly. It is possible for a spirit to return from the bardo.
Dead's dead. But if his body's up there, I'm going to find it.
Do not give up on Frank yet. This scroll will introduce you to Master Lama Kenpo. He will tell you about the bardo, how it might be entered, how a soul might be retrieved.
I don't believe a word of it, but thanks all the same.